FFW Green Card Standards, as illustrated by USCIS Cases, Part 1. Hello everyone, welcome to New Grayming Law Group's YouTube channel. Beginning today, we will discuss the detailed requirements for an NIW green card, as illustrated by a series of cases published by the USCIS. For more background information about NIW, please see our other YouTube videos. The case we discuss today was published by the USCIS several weeks ago. The applicant has a master's degree and is a healthcare data analyst. While she could have applied for an employer-sponsored PERM green card, NIW provides her with more flexibility. NIW, or National Interest Waiver, is for applicants who will substantially benefit the United States through services in sciences, arts, professions, or business. The requirement of a job offer from a U.S. employer and sponsorship from such employer for a green card is therefore waived. NIW is in the EB2 category and requires the applicant to have at least one of the following: a master's degree or higher, a bachelor's degree plus 5 years of relevant experience, or exceptional ability in one's field. Now let's look at the detailed requirements for NIW, including the three-pronged test established in the Important Matter of Donisar case, and discuss the specifics using the actual example of this healthcare data analyst's application. The first prong, which requires that the applicant's proposed endeavor has both substantial merit and national importance, focuses on the specific work that the applicant proposes to undertake. The work can be in scientific research, technology, entrepreneurship, business, health, culture, or education. Our example applicant, who is a healthcare data analyst, submitted documents showing how her statistical work can better analyze medical treatment results and patient outcomes, and thus help U.S. hospitals provide better quality care for lower costs. The USCIS found that this petitioner successfully documented both the substantial merit and national importance of her proposed research, and so she therefore meets the first prong of the NIW requirements. The second prong, which requires that the applicant is well-positioned to advance the proposed endeavor, shifts the focus from the applicant's proposed work to the applicant herself. This is often the most important prong. The USCIS will examine applicants' credentials and track record, including education, skills, plan for future activities, and record of success, as well as progress towards achieving the proposed endeavor and interest from potential customers, users, investors, or other relevant entities or individuals. In this specific case, the healthcare data analyst submitted reference letters that discussed her medical research projects involving drugs and patient health. Her research project has resulted in a journal publication, and that paper has received some citations by others. However, the USCIS pointed out that the petitioner did not demonstrate how this number of citations constitutes a record of success or a level of interest in her work from relevant parties. Now let's discuss how to improve from there. The applicant may mention how peer researchers in the hospital specifically expressed their interest in her work, and how her work has impacted the field as a whole, to demonstrate success of her research. The petition also mentioned that the applicant has contributed to several successful research grant proposals funded by the NIH, to show government interest and investment in her research. However, the USCIS cited texts from the Donisar case and noted that the Donisar applicant was the primary contact or principal investigator in research grants, while this healthcare data analyst applicant was not. Another recommendation letter from a professor stated that the petitioner played a central role in research concerning anemia management and patient outcome. However, the USCIS pointed out that the petitioner has not shown that her findings have been implemented or utilized through a change in clinical guidelines or applauded by others in the field. So let's discuss, how could she improve this? Changing clinical guidelines is quite difficult, but the applicant could have included pilot studies, active group discussions and references of her work by peers, reactions of pharmaceutical or insurance companies, etc., as proof of how her findings have been implemented or utilized. The healthcare data analyst's journal publications have been widely cited more than 100 times total, but the USCIS alleged that the petitioner has not demonstrated how that number reflects a high level of interest in her work from relevant parties. Let's discuss, how could she improve that? You cannot simply assume that you only need to list the basic facts and the USCIS will draw the conclusion automatically. You need to go step by step to explain why this information is important and how it is important. Do not skip steps. Always ask yourself, I have reached this fact, so what? What's the significance? And then go to the next natural small step, using persuasive reasoning to build your case, one step at a time. For example, let's say a husband and wife have this conversation below. Wife, I saw you dating another woman yesterday. Husband, so what? Wife, so you are not loyal to me. Husband, so what? Wife, so the basis of our love no longer exists in our marriage relationship. Husband, so what? Wife, so we cannot live together as husband and wife anymore. Husband, so what? Wife, so we need to pursue a divorce now. This conversation may look tedious, and it may look like you can jump from the first line directly to the last line. However, in legal documents, including immigration petition letters, you may have to write out each and every step explicitly to clearly show how your evidence can lead to the conclusion you draw. If you do not do this, it is possible that the USCIS will not find meaningful links between the evidence you present and the conclusion you draw. Overall, for the reasons mentioned above, the USCIS eventually found that the applicant's academic accomplishments and past works do not establish that she satisfies the second prong as described in Donisar. The third prong requires the petitioner to demonstrate that, on balance, it would be beneficial to the United States to waive the requirements of a job offer and labor certification. When performing this analysis, the USCIS evaluates factors including 1. Whether it would be impractical to require a job offer or labor certification. 2. Whether, even assuming other U.S. qualified workers are available, the United States would still benefit from the petitioner's contributions. And 3. Whether the national interest in petitioner's contributions is sufficiently urgent to warrant foregoing the labor certification process. These considered factors must, when taken together, indicate that, on balance, it would be beneficial to the U.S. to waive the requirements of a job offer and labor certification. It is often easier to establish factors 2 and 3 when the petitioner is a researcher, engineer, medical personnel, or specialist. However, for this specific case published by the USCIS, for which the petitioner is a data analyst, the USCIS found that she did not meet the second prong requirement and concluded that there is therefore no need to proceed to the third prong. We can see from this case that having a good number of publications and citations, more than 100 citations in this case, is not by itself sufficient for NIW approval. You cannot simply display the academic accomplishments and expect the USCIS to automatically acknowledge you qualify for NIW. You need to emphasize important points including 1. How others have expressed interest in your work. 2. The practical implications and impact of your work to your field and to peers. 3. Comparison to the text and reasoning in the Donisar case, which is the official standard. 4. Your documented progress in the proposed endeavor. 5. The urgency and importance of your work. And 6. Other aspects, including how your work can benefit the U.S. economy and employment of U.S. workers. That's all for today in our discussion of NIW green card standards. We will continue to analyze recently published USCIS cases with useful tips for NIW, so stay tuned on our YouTube channel. If you have questions or want a free evaluation of your case, please email info@nwmlaw.com. Thanks for listening!